abilities some consider to be unnatural.
Hi guys, it's Final Breaks here, coming to you with another video. Today I have got a collection video. So this collection is one of the biggest I've ever got. It is most of the Sith minifigures. Well, not most of them, but all the characters of Sith that I own. I included a few custom minifigures along the way. So these range from like 2008 onwards. So 2008 one is probably, well, if you ask me about how much this collection costs, it probably cost you about £50, something like that, because of how rare some of these minifigures are. So I have got my custom Darth Revan down here to include into the collection. Anyway guys, so let's dive straight in. Anyway, so we are diving straight in with one of the main villains from Star Wars. This is Darkseid Anakin Skywalker, aka Darth Vader, around about this time. So this minifigure was released in 2012. It came with Anakin's Jedi Interceptor. So it comes with his blue lightsaber. It has really nice detail. Jedi robes. Things like that. He has this was like a new colour for his hairpiece. The other one was like a lighter brown for the Clone Wars. But it has quite an angry face. If you look at the other side, he's got a Sith yellowy eyes. So that's pretty creepy. It also has a scar on each face. But yeah, as you can see, he's wearing his Jedi robes. It's brown, he's got his belt. He's got black printing on his legs. So he's also got back torso printing. Some more of his robes continuing on to the back. So yeah, this is one of my favourite minifigures. I wanted it when I was younger. Fortunately I didn't have it, so I ended up having to get it later on in years. But yeah, let's move on to the next minifigure. Anyway, so the next minifigure is quite a recent one. This is Battle Damaged Anakin Skywalker from 2017. It came with Darth Vader's transformation in 2017. Anyway, so this minifigure has an awful lot of detail. You see scarring all over the face. Scarring all over the... Well, he's got, you can see his bare chest in this one. Most of it's all burnt, scratched, things like that, torn him away. And you can see his robes are torn away as well here, as well as down here at the bottom. All you can see is flesh, like rotten flesh. He's also got some scars around here, just like in the actual film. So he's got the gunmetal grey legs to show as if it's the cybernetic legs. If we turn this around, he has got back of the head detailing as well as back torso printing. So as you can see all the burns and things. Score and scratches, all the ripped detailing. So yeah, let's move on to the next minifigure. Anyway, so the next minifigure is another battle damaged Vader. But this time, this one is from 2010 and from one of my favourite sets, Emperor Palpatine's Shuttle. So it comes with the Vader helmet for some reason, even though He had all of his suits on. He has amazing printing for his face. Absolutely amazing. Scarring in the right places. He looks as if he's in very deep pain. Unfortunately, no back print, no back of the head printing. This was back in 2010. But this was a phenomenal job for this minifigure. Especially for 2010, considering the year. He's also got like burnt, like colour, brownish colour to see that he's been burned. For some reason, the actual minifigure back in 2010 didn't come with this metallic silver lightsaber, but for some reason it just did when I got it. So it's with a chrome hilt from 1999 to at least somewhat up to like 2005 or something, or 2010. Not entirely sure, but you can also see he's got loads of detail in here. Score marks and things like that. Is yet again, his robes are torn. Really nice detailing. It's like scratches all over his skin. He has got one fleshy arm. And then if we move on to the back, see some more detailing. Robes scratched and things. So yeah, I highly recommend getting this minifigure if you ever get a chance. Anyway, so let's move on to the next minifigure. Anyway guys, so this minifigure is from Vader's Transformation as well, from 2017. So it's the same one, same Vader you usually see nowadays. I can see it was a new era with the new helmet piece, which you can separate like that. And as you can see, it's the same face as the battle-damaged Vader. Detailing's pretty basic. Like you see, it's got the armor, it's got all the control panels and things. Doesn't come with any back printing though. And he does come with this newer soft cape, which was new back in the year. But yeah, time to get onto the next minifigure. Anyway, so the next minifigure was one of my first LEGO Star Wars minifigures. It is the Vader, well, Darth Vader from the Empire Strikes Out mini movie that lasts for at least 21 minutes. Came with this exclusive minifigure. So it's basically Vader with a shiny medal, as you can see. It was very exclusive. As you see, it's got the Imperial emblem on the medal. You got detailing on it. Of course, his helmet. Sorry, this minifigure's a bit old, but yeah, it comes with awesome detailing. Really good detailing for back in the year. Of Vader's scarred face with the grayness for it. The original minifigure didn't come with these printed legs, but I just added them on. Unfortunately, he did come with a cape, but I kinda lost it somewhere, something like that. But it has no back printing. It does come with his lightsaber. But yeah, let's go on to the next minifigure. Anyway, so the next minifigure is another Vader. This time it is battle-damaged Vader from the Force Unleashed video game. It's got absolutely amazing details, as you can see. This minifigure was released in 2008, but I managed to get it a little later on eBay, I think it was. So yeah, I'm really lucky to have it. It goes for quite a bit now, so yeah. As you can see, he's got parts of his mask torn off. He's printing there. Basic printing for Vader in 2008. As you can see, all of his mechanical details on the front of his torso is all torn off because of Starkiller using the Force and things like that on him. Yeah, it's get grey to show his skin. No back printing. And it does come with this piece. It's not a new piece. It's just a upside down scuba mask thing. So if I put that back on. So from there I'm probably going to speed up the video, so yeah, because this video is getting a bit long, so yeah. Now this minifigure is a custom minifigure. It is Savage Press. It comes with his double-bladed lightsaber, yellow hands. Unfortunately I don't have another Zabrak head, so I ended up using this one from an orc and the horns from a Black Panther. I see detailing, etc. Now let's go on to the next minifigure. Now the next minifigure is Darth Maul from 2017 Duel in Naboo set. Comes with his double-bladed lightsaber, that freakish face, the horn crown piece, awesome detailing on the torso and on the legs as well as on the back. So yeah, let's go on to the next one. So yeah, here's a custom Darth Revan minifigure that I made. It comes with his purple lightsaber, which is awesome. Comes with this Sith trooper helmet, and underneath you see this angry face. It's using the pieces from the Sith trooper battle pack, and he comes with this old cape. So yeah, next minifigure. So the next minifigure is another custom. This is Darth Malgus. I used Palpatine's face from 2010 for Darth Malgus' scarred face. I used the Ninjago mask piece, half mask here. And then armor plating from the collectible series minifigure. Basic detailing from the Death Trooper. So yeah, it also comes with this lightsaber. And next minifigure. So the next minifigure is quite a rare one. This is Palpatine from Palpatine's Arrest from 2012. So as you can see, it comes with this detailing as well as his Force lightning in his hands. Back printed. It does come with this angry face, as well as this creepy face when he gets electrocuted with Force lightning and shows his, well, reveals his true Sith form. So these Force lightning pieces are absolutely amazing. I love them. Let's go on to the next minifigure. Next minifigure is this Palpatine. As you can see, comes with the angry face, as well as the other one, which is like a kind of face. So he's got detailing all over. He comes with a soft cloth cape, no back detailing or fringing. So that's a bit unfortunate. This came in Vader's transformation. So yeah, let's get on to the final part of this video. Now guys, unfortunately I wasn't able to do all of these minifigures because it would just take too long of a video. But yeah, of course. If you want to check out a full review on this custom Darth Revan minifigure, you go and check my video out. It'll be in the description below. But yeah, over the years I have been collecting all these minifigures, so even a some custom ones like Starkiller, which I'll probably do in another video, as well as Count Dooku. A couple of Sith minifigures I would like would be probably Darth Nihilus, Darth Bane, and a few other Sith minifigures. But yeah, anyway guys, that's going to be it for this video. Comment down in the comments below what kind of collection you guys would like to see next, as well as what you think of this video. Anyway guys, hope you have a nice and lovely day, and I'll see you guys in another video. Bye.